History shows that a currency not forced upon the people by some government is only desirable if it has certain specific properties. These properties are usually the consequence of the rules that govern such a currency. To try and make bitcoins a purely voluntary and digital currency attractive, Satoshi Nakamoto, the original designer of Bitcoin, decided to implement rules that would mimic rules governing real-world monies, most closely paper cash you use in your daily life and precious metals. So let's get right into what the rules are. Bitcoins, just like real-world cash, are fungible, meaning my one Bitcoin is as good as your one Bitcoin, just like my one US dollar or my 1 gram of gold is as good as your one US dollar or 1 gram of gold. Next, Bitcoins are highly divisible, more so than cash, and definitely a lot easier than precious metals. Cash is typically divided only down to 2 decimal places, while Bitcoins right now can be divided down to 8 decimal places, which means if you own 1 Bitcoin, technically without paying the 0.0005 currently mandatory fee, you could send someone 0.0000001 of that 1 Bitcoin and keep the other 0.999999. Also, there's the possibility to even increase this divisibility in the future. Despite Bitcoins being a digital currency residing exclusively within the digital world, where it takes no effort to copy a file, Nakamoto's brilliant design makes it virtually impossible to counterfeit Bitcoins, which is a huge improvement over cash and precious metals. Where Bitcoins really shine, though, is by mimicking precious metals in the supply department, where unlike governments and central banks being able to create more cash at their own discretion, the issuing of new Bitcoins is strictly limited to a by Nakamoto set maximum of 21 million Bitcoins. Currently, already 8.8 million have been issued, and as the issuing rate slows over time, it is projected it will take as far as year 2140 until the last Bitcoins get issued. After that, no one will be able to issue new Bitcoins anymore. Also mimicking precious metals, and unlike cash, there is no one, not even Satoshi himself, who can issue new Bitcoins for free. A certain amount of work by your computer is always required to be able to issue new Bitcoins. In summary, the arguably very desirable properties of Bitcoins are: they're fungible, highly divisible, very limited and scarce, it takes labor to issue them, and are practically impossible to fake. That's one pretty cool currency, wouldn't you agree? As always, please subscribe, rate, and comment. Till next time, all hail science and reason.